In this video, we will have a look at another way to compute the partial trace. And remember, we want to compute the partial trace to go from a bipartite state rho AB to the reduced state rho A, or of course rho B. In this video, I will always talk about computing the reduced state on A. This way of computing the partial trace is nice because it gives us conceptually a different way to understand the partial trace operation. Namely, we can think that the partial trace corresponds to performing a measurement on qubit B and forgetting the outcome. So let's imagine now that we're going to measure qubit B in a basis. You can convince yourself later that it doesn't matter, in fact, in which basis we perform this measurement. So let's just assume that this is the standard basis. So let's see what happens if we measure B in that basis. You know the rule for computing probabilities of outcomes. So if I measure B in the standard basis, you've already learned that the probability of obtaining outcome B is given by this expression. What is the post-measurement state if I observe outcome B? So again, using our usual rules, the post-measurement state can be computed in terms of the measurement operators, meaning that we measure on B and we do nothing on A, normalized, namely divided by the probability, which is just a trace of the top. So this is the post-measurement state if we measured B and obtained outcome little b. So I've said that computing the partial trace is like measuring B and forgetting the outcome. And in order to show this, let me now have a look at what is the reduced state on A if we did obtain outcome B. So we measure system B, we obtain outcome little b, we have a post-measurement state, which is this one, and I'm asking now what is the reduced state on A in this case. So we can just apply our rule, and here I've again just expanded rho AB as in my previous video. So rho AB is given by KLIJ for some coefficients I and J, K and L. So if I apply the rule here that the partial trace of the post-measurement state is found by just tacking on the trace operation on the B part, we will end up with this expression. So let me have a look at this. So here, looking at this term, we see that this is 0 if B is not equal to K, and 1 if B is equal to K. Similarly, this here is 0 if B is not equal to L, and 1 if B is equal to L. So this means that only the terms remain where B is equal to K is equal to L. So all the other coefficients go away, and I'm only summing over I and J, and I'm left with the terms that involve only B. So this would be the reduced state on A if I measure system B, I obtained outcome B, and I look at the post-measurement state. So here I'm again writing what is the reduced state. So I had said that we can understand the partial trace of the total state now as performing a measurement on B and forgetting the outcome. So forgetting the outcome means that we're actually going to consider the mixed state where we sum over B, and with some probability PB, we ended up with this post-measurement state, on A. So if computing the reduced state of A is like measuring B and forgetting the outcome, then this is what we would expect to get. So let's have a look at this to see whether it coincides with our rule developed in the earlier video. So what I've done here is I've just taken this expression, I've plugged it in here, and because I have PB and I divide by 1 over PB, this factor goes away, and I'm left with just this. So let me rearrange this by putting the B inside, so I end up with this sum. And you may observe that this is exactly how we had computed the partial trace. So a simpler way to compute the partial trace, sometimes simpler way, if you don't know yet what rho AB looks like, is in fact to use the fact that we can describe the partial trace as performing a measurement. In order to understand this simpler way, let me now first again look at the simpler way to compute the reduced state if we did get measurement outcome B. So let's remember that this is the state where we had computed the partial trace by again tacking on the trace on the second part. No news here, we just made that computation already. So now, note that I can write this here in a much easier way. What we have here is, because the trace is cyclic, let me in fact expand it, it is B times K L times B, and I'm going to move this, take this one and move it around to get B inner product B. So this is always 1, so the only part of the term that we really cared about is this one. And this one, of course, we can find by taking the sum here and putting B on the outside. And this is exactly what is given by this expression. So let's now use this and put this together. So putting this together, using the fact that rho AB is like measuring B and forgetting the outcome, we obtain that one way to compute the partial trace is to compute this term. So note that the probabilities again don't appear because we divide by 1 over P of B and we multiply by the same. So this is how we can compute the partial trace with respect to B.